Venkatesh and Arya are JEE aspirants and are waiting for their results. Venkatesh is hell-bent about getting admission in the prestigious IIT college, but because of dire circumstances, he has to face a calamity. It's the judgment day and they both check the JEE results stuck on a notice board.
So Venki, what is the result?
Bad. Really bad. My state rank is bottom 10. Even this time I won't be getting a seat in IIT.
Hey, don't be sad Venki. Anyways, this year's paper was tough. Even my rank is not good enough. Guess we're sinking the same ship.
It's no big deal for you Arya. This was your first attempt to do BSc. For me, this was endgame. I got no hope left in my life.
Look, Venki, don't be hard on yourself. We all know that the past month has been tough for you. I mean, nobody would have cleared JEE if they were put under the same circumstances as you are.
With this result, even my mom couldn't have been happy if she was alive. And my dad doesn't want to hear any of it. He has already wasted lakhs of rupees on my coaching institution for the past 3 years. How will I ever reveal my result to him?
You want me to speak to your dad about your results?
Please, no. You don't know my dad. Ever since mom left us, he's speaking rudely to everyone. He will probably kill me if you tell him my result.
Alright then, I won't speak to your dad about your results. But Venki, don't be sad. Cheer up and don't lose hope. Okay, bye then, I'll have to leave.
They both leave the place with disappointment. Arya's mom understood her daughter's situation, whereas Venkatesh has a hard time facing his father.
Dad, I failed.
What? You failed? Again? What is this, your third attempt or your fourth? What are you, a chronic failure or something?
Dad, I was depressed for past month. After mom left us, I couldn't focus on my studies.
Oh, stop it. It's just another excuse for wasting your entire year not studying. Where was your grief when you were playing the guitar?
Dad, please try to understand. The guitar was just a means of escape from harsh reality of life.
I don't want to hear any of it. Your batchmate Akash, that farmer's son, he cleared JEE on his first attempt, even though he had more direct conditions than you. Now, he's studying third year at IIT Bombay. If he could clear on his first attempt, why couldn't he do it on your third?
Dad, I was... Please, sorry.
I don't want to hear sorry. Every social gathering, I'm embarrassed. Whenever they ask me, what is your son doing? What am I going to say? That this is his fourth attempt for the same old JEE exam that he's been trying to answer for the past 3 years? You are with those fees I'm paying for your coaching? I'm glad your mom isn't alive to see her son being a disgrace to the family.
As a last resort to his pain and disparity, Venkatesh decides to end his life by ingesting pesticide, and in order to buy the pesticide bottle, he visits a pharmacy where he meets Arya's mom, Mrs. Sharma, who was buying prescribed medicines for her patients.
Oh, hello, Venkatesh. How was the JEE results?
It was good, auntie.
Oh, that's good. Arya couldn't make it this time. JEE is not meant for her. So, what are you doing here? Why do you need the pesticide bottle?
I need it for cockroaches.
Oh, okay then. Take care.
Arya sees Venkatesh's WhatsApp status and is distressed over it. She has a premonition that this might be Venkatesh's last words before he tries to commit suicide.
Mom, I feel there's something wrong with Venkatesh.
Oh yeah? Yes, sir. I met him at the pharmacy buying pesticides. He said it's for the cockroaches. And I noticed some changes in his behavior as well.
Oh no, I think he's trying to commit suicide because of his failure at GEE.
So he lied to me about his results. We should make him visit his home and try to inquire about his situation.
Mr. Prasad on phone and informs him about a plausible theory about Venkatesh trying to end his life. Mr. Prasad, out of curiosity, checks on Venkatesh, who is in his room with doors closed.
Hello,
Mr. Prasad trying his best to communicate to Venkatesh and convince him to open the door. Out of desperation of saving his son, he smashed open the door with force. The disclosed voice shocked Mr. Prasad, who sees Venkatesh threatening to drink the contents from the bottle of his head.
What else would I do? What differences will it for you if I die?
Look, son, if it is because of something I've said, then I'm really sorry. But suicide is not an option.
At this moment, I felt this is the right thing to do.
Mr. Prasad, please don't. Venkatesh had these thoughts because you weren't supportive enough, not because he's weak on it.
And what you are doing here?
Don't blame them. Thanks to Mrs. Sharma and Arya, if it wasn't for them, I would have lost you. I'm really sorry, Mr. Sharma. I didn't know my words would take like 20, would take such drastic steps.
Don't apologize to me, Mr. Prasad. Apologize to your son. Today your stern words have pushed him towards taking such an unthinkable action.
How could you take such a drastic step, Venki? Thank God you're safe.
I really couldn't muster the courage to drink from it.
After all, it takes more courage to live rather than ending your life. We're not taking the poison, we did the right thing, son. Suicide is never an answer to your problems. We just need to strive towards solving those problems. And have faith that everything will work out just fine. There's really no use in trying to end your life. Come on, Venkatesh. I know you can do it.
I'm really sorry. Now that I think about it, I couldn't imagine myself digesting the poison. That thought horrifies me now.
Don't be sorry, Venki. I really recommend you to seek some help, get therapy or some mental health counseling. Your mental health is equally important as your physical health. You always tend to be.
Arya is right. Luckily, I'm a mental health counselor and I've dealt with many such cases of people attempting suicide. I will take good care of you.
Thank you, Arya. You literally saved my life today. Mrs. Sharma, I should have taken your advice. Please give me an appointment for tomorrow's therapy session. And Dad, I'm really sorry. Now I'm thinking to do engineering. Anyways, I don't think I was ever meant to do IIT.
It's alright, son. You can do whatever you want. As long as you're alive, I don't care about some stupid IIT. Yeah.
Suicide is not the solution to your problems. Always keep in mind that no matter how hard the situation, it will pass. Life is like a cardiogram. If it goes down, it has to come up as well. Always remember, the more successful persons have tested more number of failures than you trying to attempt. But at the end of the day, the most important thing that matters is you attempted. You gave your best and didn't resort to
it. Here's a short poem called Troubled Heart by Ron Tramer. The moment you took your life, I felt mine ended too. If only I could turn back time, there's so much I wouldn't do. I didn't see the warning signs, you held them deep inside. Struggles you were going through, you did so well to hide. I'm left with guilt and sorrow and confusion as to why. You didn't tell me of your pain and felt you had to die. Every soul is precious in the eyes of God above. He'll heal your troubled heart with his never-ending love. I'll put my faith in him as I pray my heart will mend and keep you in my memory till I'm with you once again. Now, here's a short dance by the students of the first year BLLB program.
पायल परिंदा है तू, दिखला दे जिंदा है तू, बाकी है तुझ में हौसला। तेरी जुनू के आगे अंबर पनाहे मांगे, कर डाल तू जो फैसला।
रूठी तकदीर तो क्या, टूटी शमशीर तो क्या, टूटी शमशीरों से ही हो।